Good morning, dear students. I am Dr. Rajiv Mathur from Department of Electronics and Communication, Gitanjali Institute of Technical Studies. Today I am going to take lecture on radio wave propagation, which is part of the subject antenna and wave propagation. The radio wave propagation. Till now we have studied that antenna is a device which converts electrical energy into electromagnetic energy for wireless communication. Propagation of these electromagnetic waves, which are also called radio waves, in the free space is very important. Propagation of these radio wave largely depends upon the atmosphere of the earth. Hence it is necessary to study about the atmosphere of earth also. And it also depends on the frequency of the generated radio wave. Layers of atmosphere. There are four layers of atmosphere we can see. In light blue, near Earth surface, it is troposphere we are having, which is up to 18 kilometers. Tropopause is also there, which separates stratosphere from the troposphere. Stratosphere is around 50 kilometers above Earth surface. Ozone layer is also present here. Then we have mesosphere, which is in light blue color or purple color. Then we have ionosphere. So first we will try to understand what are the different properties of these atmospheric layers. So if we talk about troposphere, it is the most dense layer. All weather takes place here. Clouds, hail, storms, or everything takes place here, and most of the radio waves are refracted here. Short wavelengths are absorbed. Short wavelengths means higher frequency signals are absorbed and lower frequency signals are passed. The stratosphere is the second layer. It is very dry. It absorbs ultraviolet radiations radiated from the sun. Ozone layer is present here. The next layer is mesosphere. It is the coldest layer because it is above, very much at the height above the earth surface. Many meteors which comes from the outer space burns here. The most important layer of the atmosphere we have is ionosphere from the communication point of view. Region of charged region, charged ion is called ionosphere. The electrons and the positive ions are present here. This ionosphere is known to reflect most of the radio wave because of its ions in the free and the free electrons. The ionosphere reflects radio wave of certain frequencies, that is from the range of 3 MHz to 30 MHz, and the reflection makes worldwide wireless radio communication possible. Worldwide means from every part of the world we can communicate. Now this is possible using satellite. Now we can understand the different radio wave modes, which is also in layman's term called paths, radio wave paths. So as shown in the red color, the ground wave is present. The ground wave is basically the low frequency wave or large wave, not short wave. It propagates using the earth's conductivity, because at lower frequency earth acts as a conductor and at higher frequency earth acts as an insulator. So the ground wave propagation, the electric field is traveling along the ground, so it is called ground wave propagation. Next we have is sky wave propagation. In the sky wave propagation, it is meant for short wave. Whatever radio waves are there, which are ranging from 3 to 30 megahertz, are going to the atmosphere and they are reflected back from the ionosphere. So this is called sky wave propagation. And third is space wave propagation. The space wave propagation, it is, if the signal is more than 30 megahertz, then it penetrates the ionosphere and reaches to the satellite as shown in the figure above the earth surface, and it gets reflected to the earth, thereby completing the communication from source to destination. The ionosphere, as I have told you, is the most important layer, and it is also bifurcated into three layers, or we can say four layers. So first layer is D layer, which is around 85 kilometers above our surface. Then we have ionized E layer, which is around 115 to 150 kilometers above the Earth's surface. And the next layer is F layer, which is divided into two parts, that is F1 and F2 layer, which is positioned at 250 kilometers above the Earth's surface. The day and night phenomenon is also important as far as this ionospheric communication is concerned. So as you can see in the diagram, it is the sun is present at the right hand side of the figure. So when sun is present, because ionosphere is existing because of sun's radiation, so the D layer, E layer, F1 layer and F2 layer, all four layers are present during the daytime. But at night, when sunlight is not present and the sun's radiations are not able to ionize the atmosphere, then these layers are reduced into F layer. So basically F1 and F2 both layers are combined in the night time, and E layer is almost disappeared at night. D layer also is disappeared at the night. Now we talk about the different layers, characteristics of different layers. So if we talk about the structure of layer, then the D layer we are having, which is working above 10 megahertz, because up to 10 megahertz all the frequencies are absorbed in this layer. It is more ionized, and the maximum usable frequency, which is the highest frequency that can be refracted, is 16 megahertz. So below 10 megahertz it cannot, all are absorbed, and up to 16 megahertz it is the highest frequency which can be transmitted. Optimal usable frequency is 13.6 megahertz here, and the maximum ions present are O3 ions or O3 molecules. E layer, it reflects radio signal and causes them to skip back to Earth. It is weakest at the night, as we already know that at night it disappears. Maximum usable frequency is 28 MHz, and optimal usable frequency is 23.8 MHz, and maximum molecules are of oxygen. E layer, further we can say, is affected by solar. In the daytime solar winds are there, so these solar winds presses this layer towards the Earth. At night, these solar winds drags this layer of ionosphere away from the Earth. Season and sunspot activity also influence the reflection. Then lastly, F layer. F is the most important layer in terms of high frequency, because it is present both at day and night. During the day, two layers are there, and at night one layer is there. It is thickest layer. It reflects higher frequency by day but passes them through the night. The frequency of 10 to 15 megahertz are reflected back to Earth at night. The maximum usable frequency is 16 megahertz and optimal usable frequency is 13.6 megahertz. The most abundant molecules present are nitrogen and oxygens. Now, the effect of sun is also very important. The sun's magnetic field also affects the wireless communication. So this can be understood by the sun's activity from the diagram. So this is the figure. In this figure, we can see that if the sun is located at the right side, then because of its gravitational force or because of the solar winds, the push to against the Earth's surface, the Earth's electromagnetic field is basically drifting away at the right hand side. So this activity also affects the communication a lot, and there is a term called sunspot cycle, which occurs after every 11 years, also affects this phenomena and the wireless communication also in nutshell. So dear students, this is the presentation, short presentation about the layers. In the next class we will see the characteristics of all these layers in the wireless communication. Thank you very much.